Did you guys know that dragons are real? These guys may not breathe fire, but they have plenty of fantastical qualities of their own. Let me tell you about the Komodo dragon, and later I'll introduce you to a very special one named Murphy. Komodo dragons are the largest lizards in the world. The biggest one ever found weighed 366 pounds and was 10.3 feet long. They live on a handful of islands in Indonesia, including Komodo Island, hence the name. These guys are amazing eaters. They can consume up to 80% of their own body weight and can open their jaws especially wide to quickly devour their prey. And speaking of which, Komodo dragons don't particularly care what their prey is. Any type of meat will do. They've even been known to eat other Komodo dragons.
Help!
Now, the way these lizards hunt is particularly gruesome. They'll sink into an animal with their powerful jaws. But if the prey escapes, it's no big deal. Their bite may be toxic. Komodo dragon saliva is filled with bacteria that might cause blood poisoning. They also release a venom that makes their prey bleed profusely. Within a few days, the animal will die.
Uh-oh.
And then it's just a matter of finding the carcass.
Blech.
They do so by using their sense of smell, and they smell in a very special way. Like many lizards, Komodo dragons have forked tongues, and they use them to pick up molecules in the air that might indicate prey. Then they press their tongue to the roof of their mouth against a special organ that makes sense of the chemical signals. If, say, the left fork of their tongue has more prey-related molecules on it than the right fork, the Komodo dragon will know its meal is off to the left. Using their tongues, they can smell a dead animal up to 2.5 miles away. If that doesn't sound like the stuff of fantasy novels, there's one more fact about Komodo dragons that seems straight out of mythology. These animals usually have babies after a male and female mate, but female dragons can also give birth to healthy babies without mating at all. This is called parthenogenesis, and it's quite rare in animals with backbones. It was only reported in Komodo dragons for the first time in 2006 at 2 zoos in the UK. And speaking of zoos, I recently got to spend some quality time with a Komodo dragon at the zoo near me. It was one of the more special experiences of my life, and I'm delighted that I get to share it with you.
My guide on my dragon adventure was Dr. Catherine Hope.
Dr. Hope, you've had such an exciting morning. Can you tell me what you did at work today?
Today was a lot like a lot of my days at work, which are pretty much all very exciting.
That's because Dr. Hope is a veterinarian here at the National Zoo in Washington, D.C. She treats all sorts of animals. And this morning, she gave a Komodo dragon a checkup.
Komodo dragon's name is Murphy. He is going to be 20 years old this year, which is pretty up there for a Komodo dragon.
Murphy's zookeepers had noticed that he'd been a bit reluctant to move around his pen and hadn't had quite as big an appetite as usual.
So we came down today to try to do a good exam on him, see if we can identify any sources of where he might be painful or uncomfortable. And when we get blood from him, we're going to try to look at possible reasons that he might be feeling less than 100%. So whether or not one of his organs isn't working very well, or possibly if he has infection, we'll be looking for things like that in his blood work.
But before Dr. Hope could take a blood sample, Murphy had to make his way into his crate. His keepers lured him in with a trail of dead mice and other tasty treats. Crate protects Dr. Hope from Murphy's snapping jaws, but lets her draw blood from his tail.
So Komodo dragons can be quite dangerous. I'm wondering how you feel confident going in and treating a Komodo dragon as a patient. You must be extremely brave.
One of the things I always like to tell people is of all of my patients that I've ever treated, the animal that I was most scared of was a domestic cat. Because those animals in a small animal hospital, they can get really angry really fast and nobody's expecting it. Whereas here at the zoo, we're prepared for our animals to be dangerous animals. So we talk through our plans and make sure that we're not going to put ourselves into a dangerous situation. The safety level here for me is like astronomically higher than working in a dog and cat hospital.
That's so counterintuitive and fascinating.
After the blood samples, Dr. Hope and her team took x-rays of Murphy through his crate.
So the x-rays were really going to be looking for any sort of signs of arthritis because he's an old guy who's not moving quite as well.
So assuming he maybe is just getting old and is maybe getting a little arthritic, what sort of treatment would you give him to make sure that he can move properly in the future?
We can start with oral medications. He is pretty happy to take his mice, so I think giving him something by mouth every day to sort of decrease the inflammation if he's in pain.
Wait, so does that mean that you're putting pills in mice and then you're feeding them to the Komodo dragon?
Yep. Sometimes it's pills and sometimes it's like a liquid that we'll inject into the mouth and then feed it to the Komodo
dragon. Oh my gosh.
I know.
That's crazy.
Yeah. It's pretty awesome.
Dr. Hope said that if Murphy does have arthritis, they could also try laser therapy or physical therapy, which frankly, I would love to see.
That said, so far his x-rays actually look okay, and I don't see any signs of arthritis, so.
So maybe he's just getting old and slowing down a little bit, and it's just part of life?
Maybe, yeah, yeah. Or maybe it's been raining. And he doesn't want to move outside, you know?
Hey, I get that. I don't love going outside when it's rainy either. Clearly, Murphy the Komodo dragon leads a pretty charmed life. But his relatives in the wild aren't so lucky. They're currently listed as a vulnerable species, largely due to habitat loss caused by humans. But Murphy gets to eat lots of mice and has a team of humans who try to make him as happy as possible, including Dr. Hope.
I know you have kids. Do your kids think it's pretty cool that you're a dragon doctor?
Yes. My kids adore the zoo. And they love coming here and love walking around and being able to show off that their mom is a vet here. I don't know that they necessarily think of me as the dragon doctor, but I will go home and make sure I use that term with them from now on.
They're gonna think you're the coolest mom in the world.
Spending time with Murphy and Dr. Hope was a marvelous experience. Dr. Hope and all the zookeepers and scientists have such fun jobs, and they're so cool under pressure. It was a real inspiration to watch them work. And while Murphy may not be able to fly or breathe fire, in my book, he's definitely a fantastic beast. Do you have a question about Komodo dragons? Leave it in the comments or find me on Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram. And please hit subscribe and turn on notifications so you never miss a video. Hooray! Science Magic Show, Science Magic
Show, Science Magic Show. Hooray! Good Murphy. Good Murphy.